Minasan konnichiwa, this is David. I am doing a review today of the Gundam EZSR. This is the new EZSR from Build Fighters Try. It's a 1/144 HG kit. Now, just to get started to preface this, I really like this kit. It is really close to a phenomenal HG kit. It's just a couple steps away from it, but I think that some of the additional bits that you get with it sort of make it stand out and sell it. So it is a very, very good kit. I would purchase it if you're even vaguely interested in it. Now, the problem that I have with it, the biggest problem right to start out, is that these little flaps here, the sort of leg skirts, these pop off really, really easily. Both the poly cap that holds it and the actual skirt, they both pop off very easily. Whenever you're trying to pose it, it'll just come right off. That's kind of a pain in the ass because the foot has to be fussed with just a little bit to get it to balance, particularly with its other kits here. But, the other one came off while I was trying to stand it up. That's a little bit of a pain in the ass. You could work with that, though. You could put a little bit of clear paint or nail polish on the polycap itself to give it a little bit more girth, but I wouldn't actually do that too much because this is a bigger size ball polycap, and that's going to grind that away, so it will actually cut down on the life there. So the EZSR is a if you've seen the episode of Build Fighters Try that it was introduced in, it's actually three different kits. The team that used this kit had three different variant versions of it. And the version that you pick up in this kit is all three of them combined. You can swap out pieces in order to make that fit. Now, one thing worth noting, I didn't actually take apart the hands for the gun or the modular pieces for the gun, but it is actually a modular piece. I kind of like this little submachine gun thing, so I just kept it like that. But it has longer pieces that you can attach in order to turn it into kind of an assault rifle. It's got an extended barrel. It's got extra noses there. So it is actually changeable. You can make it a longer weapon if you want it to be sort of an assault piece. Also, it comes with two beam sabers. These are just standard beam sabers. There's nothing special about them. They do actually both go on the wrist there, though, which I think is kind of cool. So I guess you could actually turn these around and put the beam sabers on the wrists. So it's kind of Wolverine claw like, I don't know. So anyway, the three modes, they're all based on the backpack generally. So this is the default setting. This is the one that actually is the bulk of it. This is in the Easy Arms kit. Also, one of the others is in the Easy Arms, but I'll get to that in a moment. And it's just a couple of thrusters. And these all are on toggles, so they can be moved. The arm pieces come off. I actually like these because these are also standard sizes. You could fit pretty much any of the Build Fighters custom kits on there. I really, really like the customization on this. As well, these shoulder pieces will come out too and reveal a polycap, so those can be traded out, or you could even put, if you have the weapon kits from Build Fighters, you can actually add pieces on there. So again, really, really customizable. This chest plate, sorry, that's my son. This chest plate, which is a part of the Build Fighter specific kit, will pop off and reveal vents underneath, which is kind of cool. Also, these knee pieces here. they're all very tight. This is good. This is actually a really great thing. But then, sorry, my wife is a little under the weather as well.
Sorry.
It's okay. Usually she'd be quipping and things, yeah, no quips. But anyway, that comes off, and that can be replaced. Dade, quiet little guy. Thing about Japanese apartments is that they are small, and if you have children, they're going to get in the way. Okay, so this is the first modification. You can remove those vents there, or thrusters, and you can place this cannon on there, this machine gun style thing. And then you can remove the other one and affix this ammo pack, or I guess it might be a some sort of rocket pod, I don't know. But anyway, this one also comes with the Easy SR kit. So you'll get these pieces too if you get the Easy, or not the Easy SR, sorry, the Easy Arms. I'm a little out of it too myself. But that particular mod, you'll also have a different head for. Now these don't have the stickers on them because I hate doing stickers. I'll probably mod these myself later on. But that's sort of a commando style head. Yes, it is without underwear. Now, you remove that knee. This one has a special knee. It's got a tread. Hey, Dade, can you not sing? We don't need soundtrack. And that is so he can go down on one knee to brace his gun.
Or propose to his wife and his fiance.
Yeah. So it can be used as a tread there. It's a kind of neat little mod. And then also, you're going to get these little things right. Yeah, Dade. These little things. I'm not going to put them on because I showed you these shoulders are very tight. But they'll just clip on there. And they shorten that shoulder piece just a little bit. Okay. Now, the third mode. This is the most complicated one. And this one does not come with the Easy Arms kit. So don't expect that. Got to remove these. And again, I can't stress enough. These are really, really tight. I really like that. I've been having problems with a lot of the Build Fighters Tri kits because they don't have tight pieces and you have to either fuck with them and make them work or they just don't work very well. Okay, so this one. This one has this head, which is sort of futuristic scope looking head, I don't know. And then has these two brackets that go on to it. Fold these down. And then these two brackets support this thing. Big spaceship looking thing. I don't know what it is, honestly. I remember seeing it in the episode. I don't remember seeing what it did. So anyway, you've got this big fucking spaceship thing. And out pops this piece. Once that pops out, you can fold that up and tilt it downward and it affixes to the head. If you know why the fuck that is, leave it in the comments, please, because I have no idea. It's kind of neat looking. I don't know. It definitely is the most unique of all three of them.
Because giant robots.
Yeah. This version has a shield. It's just your normal, everyday shield type piece. Oh, and then the shield also has this, which I neglected to put on. Dave. Quiet. Also, we have these. Let me see how those work. Oh, these are actually shoulder pieces. See, this is the first time I've done this. I probably should have done a practice run. Dave, calm down. Okay, and so there we have those shoulders, which have rocket pods on them. And then we also have these little things come off for this particular version and become weapon-like vents. So there, we have a lot of different options here. So those are the three forms of this EZSR. I am genuinely considering getting all three, just because there's so much variety in there and they all are very distinct kits. Definitely worth it there. Also, this kit comes with a lot of extra runner pieces. It comes with extra shoulders, some extra joint pieces, a couple of extra foot extensions. Also comes with one more head. It's very close to the first head. Comes with a couple of extra plates. These look like the shoulder plates. I don't know if they're directly compatible. Oh no, those are extra plates for the wrists. So we actually have a ton of extra parts on here.
That head looks like Rubber Johnny.
A little bit, doesn't it? Yeah, it's like I don't even know what it is. It looks like a UFO.
It looks like Apex Twin did Gundam.
Yeah. I like it. I think it's neat. That's a hard one. Until I get another two, I don't know how I'm gonna put this one. I kind of like all three of the forms quite a bit. So I'm sold. So far, this and the Build Burning Gundam are easily my favorites in the tri line so far. Honestly, if this had better feet, it would be one of my favorite HG kits of all time. I like it a whole bunch. At least as far as like normal humanoid ones go, it's no Kshatriya. But what is? So anyway, here you go. It's the EZSR. It is, it's about 1500 yen, I think. It's new. It's good stuff. If you are even vaguely interested in it, I would check it out. Also, the colors, as my wife pointed out earlier, it kind of looks like it is unpainted. Of course, it is unpainted, but it looks explicitly so. Kind of looks primed. So you could actually do a lot really easily with coloring here. Also, a lot of great plates for panel lining. So if you are new to panel lining, this is a great place to start. So anyway, you like our videos. Like us, subscribe to us, drop a comment. If you have any requests, we have been getting quite a few of them. I would love to hear some more. I know a couple of people have been asking about the perfect grade unicorn. So, yeah, that's a white whale if there ever was one. So if I have $300 to blow, I'll try to do that. So thank you guys for your time. Check us out. Thank you.